Hallelujah. We welcome you to this morning English worship. Amen. Shall we all stand up to our feet and bless His name, for He is good, with a thankful heart. Lord, I come before you today with a thankful heart. I give you praise. Amen. Lord, we thank you for all the wonderful things which you have did in our life. Amen. Come join with us, sing to Him and praise His name. Amen. I come before you today, and there's just one thing that I want to say. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all you've given to me, for all the blessings that I can see. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an awesome charm, I bless your name. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you. For all you've done in my life, you took my sickness, you took my darkness, and you gave me life. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You took my sin and my shame, you took my weakness and healed all my pain. Lord, thank you, Lord. With a grateful heart, with a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an awesome shout, I bless your name. Blessing that I cannot see. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, with an answer strong, I bless your name. With a grateful heart, with a song of praise, Put your hands together and praise Him, for He is good. We thank You, Lord. You took my sickness, You took my shame, all my pain in Jesus' name. We thank You, Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's all continue to praise Him. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give thanks to the Lord. Amen. Amen. For He is good, and His love endureth forever. Yes. Let's all put our hands together and praise Him. Amen. To the Lord, a God and King, His love endureth forever. For He is good, He's above all the things. His love endureth forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. You say, sing praise. His love endureth forever. For the life that's been reborn, His love endureth forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. You sing, sing praise forever. God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever and ever, forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever. Rising to the setting sun, His love endureth forever. By the grace of God, we will carry on. His love endureth forever. Sing praise. Faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, yes, yes, forever and ever, forever God is faithful, forever God is strong, forever God is with us, forever. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, His love endureth forever. For the light has been reborn, His love endureth forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing. Setting sun, His love endureth forever. By the grace of God, we will carry on. His life endured forever. Sing praise. You sing. Faithful God, He is sustaining you, He is providing you, He will take care of you and lead you till the end. Amen. Do not be discouraged, do not be dismayed, for He is with you forever and ever. You all give thanks to Him, for He is good. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are my love and my light. You are the reason for singing. Amen. Hallelujah. You and me are alive this morning because of His grace and mercy. Hallelujah. Let's all put our hands together and praise Him, for He deserves it. Amen. You are my love and my life. You are my love and my life. You are my purpose for living. You are my hope in the night, my reason for singing. You bring the joy to my life, making it better and better. Oh, oh, oh. And I will give thanks forever and ever. Sing with me. You are my love and my life. You are my purpose for living. You are my hope. Singing, you bring the joy to my life, and you're making it better and better. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And I will give thanks forever and ever. We will ever know what we've been given. He has chosen us and called us His own. Flowing from His throne, there is a river, bringing life and health wherever it goes. You are my life, my life. You are my purpose for singing. You are my hope in the night, my reason for singing. You bring the joy to my life, making it better and better. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And I will give thanks forever and ever. You are my love and my life. You are my purpose for singing. You are my hope and my reason for singing. You bring the joy to my life, and you're making it better and better. Of praise. Teach us, Lord, we pray, to live in Your presence. make us more and more like you every day. You are my love and my life. You are my purpose for living. You are my hope in the night, my reason for singing. You bring the joy to my life. You're making it better and better. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And I will give thanks forever and ever. Sing it again. You are my love and my life. You are my purpose for living. You are my hope in the night, my reason for singing. You bring the joy to my life. And you're making it better and better. What a joy to know. Oh, 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 a Father loves us so. You are my love and my life. You are my purpose for living. Yes, yeah. You are my hope in the night, my reason for singing. You bring the joy to my life, and you're making it better and better. Praise Him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He loves us so much. He loves us so much, Lord. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your abundant grace. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's all worship Him. All heavens declare the glory of the risen Lord. Amen. Who can compare the beauty of the Lord? He's so marvelous. He's so amazing. His love will never fail. All heaven declare the glory of the risen Lord. Who can with the beauty of the Lord? All heavens declare. All heavens declare the glory of the risen Lord. Who can compare with the beauty of the Lord? Forever He will be the Lamb upon the throne. I gladly bow my knee worship you alone. Sing it. Forever He will be. Forever He will be the Lamb upon the throne. The Lamb upon the throne. I gladly bow my knee. Bow my knee. Worship you, my Lord. The glory of the risen Lord, who once was slain to reconcile man to God. gladly bow my knee, bow my knee to worship you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. With love and strength for each new day, He will make a way. He will make a way. Join and sing with me. God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. Love and strength for each new day, He will make a way. He will make a way. By a roadway in the wilderness, You lead me. Rivers in the desert will I see. Heaven and earth will fade, but His word will still remain. He will do something new today. God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. With love and strength for each new day, He will make a way. He will make a way. By a roadway, by a roadway in the wilderness, He will lead me. In rivers, rivers in the desert will I see. In heaven and earth will fade, but His word will still remain. He will do something new today. God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way. 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 Do not be worried. Do not be dismayed. He can make a way in the wilderness. Your life could be a wilderness this morning. Your life could be a desert this morning. But children of God, I promise you, our God is a miracle working God. Amen. He can make way whether you can't see a way. He can make rivers in the desert. Hallelujah. He can turn your sorrows into joy. Amen. Hallelujah. He's the light in the darkness. Hallelujah. We need not worry about anything of the situations around us. For He lives. We can face tomorrow because He lives. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's all sing together. Because He lives, I can face tomorrow. Because He lives, all fear is gone. Because I know, yes, I know He holds my future. treasure. My life is worth living just because it lives. You sing with me. Because it lives, I can face tomorrow. Because it lives, all fear is gone. Because worth living just because He lives, because He lives. I can face tomorrow, yeah, yeah, because He lives. All fear is gone, because I know, yes, I know. Because it lives, my life is worth living just because it lives. My life is worth living just because it lives. Now is the time to raise our hands in heaven to the mighty one, to the true one. Praise for His mighty power. He got the punishment for our sin, and He rose again. He rose again. He rose again. He rose again. Thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus. Thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus. And now is the time. Raise our hand to heaven, to the mighty one, to the true one. Praise for His mighty power. He got the punishment for our sin. He rose again. He rose again. He rose again. Thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus. Worship Him. Thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus. Thank you, God, for your Son. Thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus. Thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus. Lift up your hands and say, thank you, God, for your Son, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Your love makes me say hallelujah. 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 Your love makes me say hallelujah. Put hands lifted up. Hallelujah. Your love makes me say
Hallelujah, 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 your love makes me sing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Sing with me. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Lord, we give all glory and honor to you. In Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you all. Amen. Now is the time to bring your tithes and offering. Hallelujah. Let us be a rejoicing giver unto the Lord. Amen.
Wonderful, so wonderful is your unfailing love. Your cross is spoken, mercy over me. No eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart could fully know the glory and how marvelous you are. Beautiful one, I love, beautiful one.
Should lack in the life. Amen, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Master God. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Greetings to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm so happy to connect with you this morning. Our God is a good God. Amen. Hallelujah. You and me are safe today is because of God's grace. Let's be thankful to God for His goodness and mercy in our lives. Hallelujah. Our God is a prayer answering God. Even this morning, I want to turn your Bibles to Mark chapter 5, verse number 34. The Gospel of Mark, chapter number 5, verse number 34. To help everyone, I'm going to read from the New International Version. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for your grace. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy. Thank you for bringing us together in this manner, even as we meditate your word. Speak to us, O God. We open our hearts, we open our ears. Give us the manna for this day. Even as I speak, O Lord, empower my words. Let your name be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I want to speak to you on the topic, faith in the midst of despair. Faith in the midst of despair. When you and me are given up by the people of this world, and when we have been pushed to an extent where nobody could help us, the last resort for any humankind is a Lord, a God, the Lord Jesus Christ. Gospel of Mark, chapter number 5, is one of my favorite chapters. In this chapter, there are at least 3 miracles recorded by the gospel writer. Number 1, a demon-possessed man was totally delivered from his spiritual oppression. Then there was a woman with the issue of blood for 12 long years were healed. Number 3, a synagogue leader by name Jairus, his daughter, was raised from the dead. All these 3 miracles are miracles that gives hope for the people in a hopeless situation. In these 3 miracles, there are a few things that we can observe. In the first miracle, there was a man who was spiritually oppressed. He was insane. He was not of his mind. He was a man who lived in tombs, and many people were trying to chain him, but nobody could control him. He was out of control. And such a man, when he saw Jesus, the spirit that was in him spoke and requested the Lord Jesus not to torment him, but the Lord Jesus delivered this man and he was totally healed. Jesus has power even in the spirit world, and this is one of the example how a Lord could deliver somebody who was psychologically affected, you know, and totally out of control, given up by doctors, a man who lives in the tomb for days and day and night. He used to scream to top of his voice, being, you know, in the middle of the nights. He used to scream in the top of his voice and everybody could hear him, but nobody could control him. But at the command of our Lord Jesus Christ, the demons that were tormenting this man was spiritually affected, was totally delivered, and he was completely normal. The scripture says, when the people of the town, they came and saw this man, they were astonished. And because there was lot of loss of pigs, swains, the people in that area were afraid of the Lord Jesus Christ, and they said, kindly, please leave our place. After such incident, our Lord Jesus came to the other side of the lake, and there was a leader. His name was Jairus. The Bible mentions that he was one of the synagogue leaders. Verse number 22, when he saw Jesus, he fell at his feet. He pleaded earnestly with him, "My daughter is dying. Please come and put your hands on her so that she will be healed and live." Verse number 24, so Jesus went with him. Dear friends, I want you to let you know, who is this Jairus? Jairus was a synagogue leader, otherwise a prayer house, a house of prayer where Jewish families gather together and offer their prayers. In that synagogue, a duty, a responsibility of the synagogue leader is to assign prayers and Bible readings to different members of their congregation, which was supposed to be a highly respected role in the society. Jairus was a respected man in his society because he was a synagogue leader. But for the sake of his daughter, he was willing to give up all prejudice, all social status, and he came and surrendered at the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ. I want to tell you, this is not an accident. How would I tell you? Well, come back to you. Jairus decided in his heart, when he found his daughter is dying and there is only one man who could help, that was the Lord Jesus Christ. So he had informed his family or his immediate people that, "I am going to see Jesus. I am going to request him to an extent. I don't mind giving up my social status. I do not mind even the whole group of Pharisees opposes me. I would still fall at the feet of Jesus for my daughter's sake because I want her to be healed." He himself was a Pharisee. The Pharisees during the time of Jesus did not accept the Lord Jesus as the Messiah. They rejected him openly. In such situation, here we see a man who is a religious leader, and he comes and falling at the feet of Jesus and asking him to come to his home, touch his daughter so that she will be delivered. Jairus had total faith in the Lord Jesus Christ to be healed. And to this, his request, the Lord Jesus, obliged. And he was traveling. He was humbling himself. We could see his humility. We could see his faith on the Lord Jesus Christ. As the crowd followed Jesus towards the Jairus' house, there was a woman with an issue of blood for 12 long years. Scripture says in verse number 25 onwards, 25, 26, it says she had suffered a great deal under care of many doctors, had spent all she had, yet instead of getting better, she grew worse. But when she heard about Jesus, she came up behind him in a crowd and touched his cloak, because she thought, if I touch his clothes, I will be healed. Here we see this woman was suffering with the issue of blood. During the time of Jesus, in their culture, when a woman has an issue of blood, she has to be away from her household responsibilities, social mingling, and religious rituals. Generally, for women, the issue of blood is for a few days. But this lady suffered continually for 12 long years. Few things that we could notice from this portion. She tried all her best. The best of best doctors and all her wealth, all her income, or most of her money had been spent towards her medical expenses. Even then, she did not get better, but worse. In such situation, she heard about the Lord Jesus Christ, and she decided in her heart that if I could touch the Lord Jesus' garment, the cloak, the hem of his garment, I will be healed. Since women with this kind of health condition are not allowed to come to a public place, or she could not make a request because she can't come to a public place, she wanted to touch our Lord secretly, but she had a faith that she will be healed completely when she touches our Lord Jesus Christ. And the scripture says, verse number 29, it says, immediately, everybody say immediately. Immediately, her bleeding stopped and she felt in her body that she was freed from her suffering. Because she had faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, she intended to touch, to be healed by the power of the Lord Jesus Christ. She could immediately feel the deliverance. not only her. Verse number 30. At once Jesus realized that power had gone out from him. He turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who touched my clothes?" The disciples of Jesus, Peter and others, would have thought, "Lord, have you lost your equilibrium to say that who touched me? Don't you see that so many of us are walking along with you? People wanted to, you know, be with you. People wanted to see what is your next move. And they are walking every places that you go. And now you are asking, who touched me?" It's obvious that many people are touching you at one given time. Verse number 32. Jesus kept looking around to see who had done it. Then the woman, knowing what had happened to her, came, fell at his feet, and trembling with fear, told the whole truth. Verse number 34. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." The Lord Jesus, the moment she came at the feet of Jesus, trembling, she told that, "I could feel the touch of my suffering being stopped. I felt a miracle touch." When she said that, the Lord Jesus said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you." My dear friends, even today, your faith on the Lord Jesus can heal you. We see a contrast. In Jairus' case, Jairus was entrusted of our Lord Jesus to come to his home and touch his daughter so that she will be healed. That was his faith. But the woman's faith, this woman's faith was the other way around. "I don't want the Lord Jesus to touch me, but even if I could touch the cloak, the hem of his garment, edge of his garment, I will be healed." That was this lady's faith. No matter what level of faith you have on the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord Jesus want to honor your faith. Amen. He says, no matter how you know, what kind of faith you have in God, whether it is small or big, whether by touching or just, you know, you touch the edge of his garment, the moment you have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, your miracle is on the way. Amen. You will be totally healed, delivered. That is what we see. And the Lord Jesus not only said that, he said, "Your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." That means this healing is not temporary, but forever. Not is a momentary healing, but a permanent healing by our Lord Jesus Christ. That was the great thing. So the Lord Jesus said, "You go in peace. From today, you will be freed from all your suffering. You can be normal. You can do your household work. You can socialize. You can go to house of prayers." That was the great freedom this lady could have after 12 long years. And that's the time we see in the Bible. Some people came from the house of Jairus, the synagogue leader. They said, "Your daughter is dead. Why bother the teacher anymore?" Which means Jairus has already decided, informed in advance to his house, saying that, "I am going to see the Lord Jesus. I am going to ask him to come to our home. If the Lord Jesus could come to our home and touch my daughter, she will be healed. That was his faith. Overhearing what the people who came from his house said, the Lord Jesus told Jairus, Jairus, don't be afraid, just believe. Don't be afraid that your daughter is gone forever. Just believe. Let's keep going. That's what Jesus said. And when he went near their home, he did not let anyone except Peter, James, John, three of his disciples. When they came to the house of Jairus, there was big commotion because there were professional mourners wailing loudly. He said unto them, well, this child is not dead, but asleep. And everyone, literally, they mocked at the Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus put all of them out of their house. He took the parents and the three disciples. And he took her by hand and said to her, Talitha cum, which means, little girl, I say to you, get up. Immediately, the little girl stood up and began to walk around. And scripture says she was 12 years old. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When the servants or people from his house came and told Jairus, your daughter is dead, can you imagine the father's heart? At that moment, the Lord Jesus said, don't be afraid, Jairus, just believe. That was great faith, I tell you. It was great faith. At least when his daughter was alive, he thought Jesus could come and heal her. Now she is dead. He was worried. But the very words of Jesus, the words that came out of the Lord Jesus Christ, comforted Jairus and gave great faith. Jesus said, don't be afraid, just believe. And he believed and walked with them. Otherwise, he would have told Jesus, Lord Jesus, don't worry. I will go and take care of the funeral arrangements. But he believed the Lord Jesus and followed him. Because of that, he could see his dead daughter coming back to life. Hallelujah. You see, there is a correlation between these two. This woman was suffering for 12 long years with the issue of blood. And this girl, little girl, was 12 years old. That means 12 years is a very long time. And Jesus, you know, was able to deliver a woman who's suffering for 12 long years. And Jesus was able to raise a dead girl who was 12 years. And he gave her many more years to live after that. Hallelujah. Dear friends, have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. In the midst of despair, in the midst of hopeless situation, no matter what was your need this morning, you need to have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ that could heal you, that could deliver you. For the people who are already grown in Christ, and you would say, Pastor, I have heard this story for very many years. What is there for me? To you, I want to tell you, my dear friends, wherever the Lord Jesus went, there was interruption. The interruption was for healing and deliverance. Wherever Jesus walked during his ministerial time, people interrupted him and asked him to help him, asked him to heal him. And Jesus was willing to listen to them and, heal them, deliver them. You and me, as a child of God, as a man and a woman of God, in our faith journey, we might come across many people interrupting us, asking for help, knowing that you are a man of faith, a woman of faith, a man of prayer, a woman of prayer. I want to tell you, my dear friends, exercise your faith. Exercise your faith and tell them, my Lord Jesus is able, is more than able. I pray for you right now. You will be delivered. You will be set free from your problems, from your sickness, from your bondage. Be a man or a woman of faith who exercise in your own life and others' life. If you are a person who have given up despair and depressed, and you don't want a Lord to be interrupted, I want to tell you, it is okay. Day or night, you can interrupt our Lord Jesus Christ, because Scripture says, a Lord our God, He will not slumber nor sleep. The God of Israel, He will not slumber nor sleep. He doesn't take rest. He's always there for you. My dear friend, it's okay to interrupt our Lord Jesus Christ, our God Almighty. He might be on the way to something else, but you can interrupt him to receive your healing. If you are desperate, if you are despair, if you are hungry, if you are thirsty, you can ask the Lord Jesus Christ and he can heal you. Hallelujah. See the way Lord Jesus relates to people, to this woman. He was very kind in saying, daughter, daughter, anyone who has faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, they becomes daughter and son to a Lord Jesus. We all become the children of God. The moment you have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, we become the children of God. Hallelujah. That's how the Lord Jesus related to her. Daughter, your faith has healed you. There is a new relationship the moment you have faith in the Lord. If you want to have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, all that you need to do today is, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. Forgive my sins. Come into my heart. From this day forward, I want to serve you. I want to follow you. I want you to be my Lord and my Savior. I surrender my life to you. The moment you say that, you become the daughter and son of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. There is a new relationship. No matter how old are you, you have been given a new relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. I was very, touched by this word, Talitha Kum, which means little girl, I say to you, get up. Talitha is a feminine word of little lamp. That's how Jesus you know, took this dead girl in his hand and he said, "Little lamb, I say to you, get up, wake up." See the way the Lord Jesus had compassionate and loving towards people. If you and me, as a man, a woman of God, as a child of God, we need to be compassionate and loving to the people who are in need, who are suffering, who are looking for deliverance and healing. Don't shun them away. Don't shun them away to go there and here and there. You be a channel of blessing. You be a point of healing. You be a point of miracle and deliverance unto the life. Speak life to the people who come to you with despair. Speak deliverance to the people who come with you with bondages. Speak hope to the people who come with hopelessness. Pray that God would make you a person who exercise your faith to the maximum. And if you are a person looking for a miracle, exercise your faith and see the hand of God delivering, healing, and walk a victorious Christian life. God bless you. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful morning that you have given us. Even as we have meditated from the life of these two, O Lord, people who were desperate, they were despair, and they have put their faith in you, and they have received their miracle. Our faith is strengthened this morning. Lord, no matter what level of faith we have in the Lord Jesus Christ, you honor our faith. Whether it's being touched, or we touch, or just say one word, and we will be healed. No matter what level of faith, you honor our faith. Lord, help us to have faith in you in the midst of despair. I pray for all those who need miracle touch this morning. You would touch them and heal them, deliver them. Every bondages in their life will be broken in Jesus' name. We pray for all the believers who are already walking with the Lord. Pray that in their faith journey, when they see people with despair and hopelessness, let them be a channel of blessing, bringing healing and deliverance. Pray, O God, even as we are, every one of us are locked inside our homes, in our place of stay, O Lord, not able to go out. We pray, O Jesus, help us to, O Lord, put all our hope. And we declare this morning, O Lord, you are our last resort. And you will never let us down. You will always give us deliverance and victory. Be with your children and minister to them in a supernatural way. In the mighty, never failing name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of the Father, fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each and every one of us now and forevermore. God bless you. See you next week.